Hi, it's me, Dr. Prasad Potila, with another lab experiment, chemical oxygen demand. So chemical oxygen demand, it is can be defined as the milligram amount of oxygen which is required for the oxidation of organic matter present in 1 liter of wastewater sample. So COD test, it requires a strong oxidizing agent. We can use potassium dichromate, potassium permanganate, or CeSO4 as a strong oxidizing agent. But the best suitable oxidant for a COD test is potassium dichromate. So here what is happening, the water sample, if it contains organic impurities, that is industrial, mainly the industrial water, if it contains organic impurities, the organic impurities will consume the oxygen present in the water, or the oxygen demand will be present in that water will be less, or we can add more oxygen to that, or it has got high oxygen demand. High oxygen demand, it indicates that the water is almost impure water, or it is containing contamination. Therefore, this test is performed to analyze the impurity level present in the water sample. So oxidation of this organic matter present in water can also be done with aerobic conditions. Bacteria culture is used as an oxidizing medium, which is called as biological oxygen demand. Since a certain organic compounds present in the industrial wastewater, it is inert to the biological oxidation, or it cannot be oxidized by using the bacteria. Therefore, we may not get the accurate result with biological oxygen demand test. Whereas the advantages of COD over BOD is that it requires around 3 to 5 hours to complete the estimation procedure. Whereas BOD test, it requires 5 days. It has to be kept in incubation and the bacteria culture has to oxidize the organic impurities. So it requires more time, BOD requires 5 days. Whereas COD experiment, it can be performed within 6 hours. And most of the organic compound present in the water can be oxidized by using the strong oxidizing agent, which is potassium dichromate, and we can estimate the amount of oxygen supplied. The wastewater contains mainly the organic impurities such as aliphatic compounds, aromatic hydrocarbons, alcohols, pyridine, and other oxidizable matter. If the water contains a straight chain aliphatic or aromatic compound, if you know that the water contains this particular organic compound, then potassium dichromate alone cannot oxidize it. It requires a catalyst. Therefore, silver sulfate is used as a catalyst in that case. And if the water contains chlorides, chlorides may interfere the reaction and it can be eliminated by adding mercuric sulfate, HgSO4. Before adding any other reagent, this chemical should be added to that water sample. And the complete oxidation reaction to happen, the reaction ratio or the acid to sample dichromate ratio should be maintained as 1:1. That means we have to take equal volume of water sample dichromate mixture and that of sulfuric acid. Determination of chemical oxygen demand, it is based on the principle that when the water sample is refluxed with non-excess amount of potassium dichromate in acid media in presence of mercuric sulfate, the organic matter is oxidized to carbon dioxide and water. The unreacted potassium dichromate, it can be estimated by using ferrous ammonium sulfate mainly. So the reaction mixture containing unreacted potassium dichromate is determined by titrating with that of FAS solution with the ferroin, as mainly we use the ferroin as the indicator. Knowing the amount of potassium dichromate consumed, it is possible to calculate the amount of oxygen in milligram per liter. So this is the principal reaction given. The organic matter or wastewater containing organic impurities, it reacts with K2Cr2S and potassium dichromate in sulfuric acid medium to give K2SO4 plus Cr2SO4. Potassium dichromate is reduced, whereas the organic matter is oxidized to carbon dioxide and water. The unreacted potassium dichromate, it can be estimated by reacting with ferrous ammonium sulfate or FeSO4. So K2Cr2O7 plus 7H2SO4 plus 6FeSO4 gives K2SO4 plus Cr2SO4 thrice plus 3Fe2SO4 thrice plus 7H2O. And here also we can use an indicator, ferroin, as mainly as the indicator. So when we use ferroiron, that is 110 phenanthrene iron complex, this property or this nature already explained in nitrate estimation in my the same series of classes. So 110 phenanthrene is one of the best indicator to find the redox titration. Even diphenylamine can also be used as an indicator. Not only diphenylamine, diphenyl benzidine and diphenylamine sulfonate, they also can be used, which gives the color change from the oxidized state to reduced state. The color changes will be green to violet. Here the standard reduction potential for this conversion reaction, that is 0.78 volt for that of the indicator. And according to Kolthoff and Sanders, there should be a potential difference between two chemicals which undergoing reduction, then only the reduction takes place. So in this case, in case of iron, this may not be the case. Therefore, we have to add phosphoric acid to stabilize the Fe3+. We need to prepare a ferrous ammonium sulfate standard solution. We need to calculate its normality or strength. To calculate ferrous ammonium sulfate normality, we may require its equivalent weight, that is 392.13. We have to prepare a standard potassium dichromate solution. We need to calculate its strength. Mainly, we calculate normality. To calculate normality, its equivalent weight is 49. And there are two titrations, like blank titration as well as batch titration. The difference in between these two is that in blank titration, we are not using the water sample or the water which we want to estimate. Other things are maintained as such. That is, distilled water is added, sulfuric acid is added, potassium dichromate is added, then it is refluxed for 2 hours, then cooled, titrated against ferrous ammonium sulfate solution using suitable indicator. And the titrate volume, we take it as V2 ml. And in back titration, the water sample is mixed with potassium dichromate. So potassium dichromate will be used by the water sample. Potassium dichromate oxidizes the water sample. During the refluxation. Refluxation is done because the chemicals are not allowed to escape. It is condensed back and complete reaction is taking place. Then after the reaction with the organic impurities, whatever potassium dichromate remaining back, that is titrated against FAS, therefore the name back titration, and let the volume as V1 ml. Therefore, we got two volumes. V2 will be higher volume because there is no wastewater, there is no organic impurities present in that conical flask or Elmer flask where we take the sample. Therefore, V2 is higher volume, V1 is a smaller volume. The difference of V2 minus V1 will give the volume of potassium dichromate required for the oxidation of the organic matter. So by using that volume, that is the volume of oxygen that we are supplying. Potassium dichromate we use as an oxidizing agent, means it is an agent which supplies oxygen to react with the organic impurities. Therefore, from that, we can calculate the normality of the solution. And from by getting the normality, we can calculate the amount as normality multiplied by equivalent weight. So here equivalent weight of oxygen, we consider as 8. So the value obtained, it is in gram per liter. As per the definition of a COD, we need to convert into milligram per liter. Therefore, the final result we expressed as a milligram per liter of oxygen. That is the chemical oxygen demand. I think hope you understood this concept of chemical oxygen demand experiment in our lab. Thank you very much for watching this video and have a nice day.